ونقدس على آلائه ونعمائه ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله أرسله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله اللهم صل وسلم وبارك وترحم على محمد وآل محمد كأفضل ما صليت وسلمت وباركت وترحمت على إبراهيم وآل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد وصل اللهم وسلم على خلفاء نبيك وأوصيائه وأهل بيته علي أمير المؤمنين وقائد الغر المحجلين وعلى البضعة الطاهرة فاطمة الزهراء سيدة نساء العالمين وعلى سبطي نبي الرحمة وسيدي شباب أهل الجنة الحسن والحسين عليهم السلام وعلى علي بن الحسين ومحمد بن علي وجعفر بن محمد وموسى بن جعفر وعلي بن موسى ومحمد بن علي وعلي بن محمد والحسن بن علي والخلف الهادي المهدي عجل الله تعالى فرجه وسهل مخرجه وجعلنا من أنصاره وأعوانه عباد الله أوصيكم وأوصي نفسي بتقوى الله ولزوم أمره أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم استكبارا في الأرض ومكر السيء ولا يحيق المكر السيء إلا بأهله فهل ينظرون إلا سنة الأولين فلن تجد لسنة الله تبديلا ولن تجد لسنة الله تحويلا صدق الله العلي العظيم. There is a very important and formidable law in the Holy Quran. وَلَا يَحِيقُ الْمَكْرُ السَّيِّئُ إِلَّا بِأَهْلِهِ Always the evil plan that someone masters and designs against others, the evil plan that someone articulates and designs against others is going to haunt him down one day. The loser is going to be that person who's the maker, the designer of this evil deed. وَلَا يَحِيقُ الْمَكْرُ السَّيِّئُ إِلَّا بِهِ If someone draws plans against his friends, his neighbors, people in the community, others, his rivals in business, usually it happens when among the business people, to destroy his rivals. So he sits and he plans against them. Allah says eventually this plan is going to come back after him. It's going to turn after him. Whether it's in business, whether it's in marriage, in divorce, in family, in school, and also in politics. And this is what we saw yesterday happening in Saudi Arabia, in one of the masajid in the city of Abha, the province of Asir in Saudi Arabia. Although we feel unhappy about what happened, people are performing Salatul Dhuhr, and a suicide bomber comes inside the masjid and he kills 15 at least, 15 of them, who belong to the military. But this is what we warned against for so many times, that countries that finances terrorism, Wahhabism, takfirism, they encourage, they promote, they brainwash the young people and send them outside to kill people in Afghanistan and Pakistan and Syria and Yemen and Iraq and Egypt and left and right, those people one day will pay the price. And this is what happened yesterday. And that is the beginning, the first to drop. They are paying the price. In Arabic, they have a proverb, ضَرْبُ الْمَثَلِ وَعَلَى نَفْسِهَا جَلَتْ بَرَاقِشْ Those of you who understand Arabic. And in English also, they have a proverb. It says that the chickens have come home to roost. The chickens have come home to roost. When people were killed in these countries by Daesh, by Al-Qaeda, by Takfiris, Those people in Saudi Arabia and the Gulf countries, they overlooked that. They were deaf. They were blind. They did not even condemn. Because the one who was killed is someone from Pakistan, Afghanistan, Iraq, Syria, this country and that country. But today, the Mufti of Saudi Arabia, he starts condemning takfirism. This is barbarism. This is against Islam. Where were you for 30 years? Where were you? For 30 years, these acts were Islamic and ethical. Today, because it happened against the armed forces in Saudi Arabia, now it is unethical and Islamic? This is hypocrisy. This is hypocrisy. So, Allah says, those who plan, at the end, these planning and these plots will hunt them down. Will hunt them down. مَنْ حَفَرَ بِئْرًا لِأَخِيهِ وَقَعَ فِيهَا. If someone digs a hole for his brother to fill it, to fall in that hole, he himself would fall in that hole one day. And this is exactly what happened. You've heard me here. If you don't remember, go to the recordings. I said many times that these countries who promote extremism, radicalism, Wahhabism, hate, they're going to pay the price. And this price that they paid yesterday is nothing. This is an appetizer, small salad appetizer. They're going to pay a bigger price, bigger price. People who are responsible for the destruction of Iraq and Syria and Yemen and many other countries, Allah is absent, He doesn't see. He doesn't see that those countries, they pay money, billions of dollars, rather than building hospitals and clinics and schools and universities and making Muslim countries thrive. You know how many Muslims are drowning in the Mediterranean on a daily basis? Do you read the news? Do you follow the news? Almost every day. People from North Africa, from Algeria, from Tunisia, from other countries, from Morocco. They drown. Why they drown? Because their countries are disasters. They don't find jobs. There is no dignity. There is no healthcare. There is no education. So they seek refuge in Europe. Why should Muslims seek refuge in Europe? What's wrong with Muslim countries? Because the money is spent on what? On war. Purchasing arms to kill Muslims, to kill each other. So we saw the result of it yesterday. Although we feel sorry for that, and we condemn every barbaric act against any human, be it Shi'a, Sunni, Muslim, non-Muslim. This is not the ethics of Islam. To go into a masjid, a temple, a church, a synagogue, and kill worshippers. This is not the ethics of Islam. Islam condemns this strongly. What I am saying is that I hope it will be a lesson for those who financed Wahhabism and terrorism for at least 3 decades. I hope it would be a lesson for them, because Allah says in the Quran, هَذِهِ بِضَاعَتُكُمْ رُدَّتْ إِلَيْكُمْ. This is what you did to others, now it is turning against you. إِنَّ رَبَّكَ لَبِالْمِرْصَادِ. The government of God, His justice system, is very strict. We hope, inshallah, Allah will bring understanding and healing and unity to the Muslim Ummah worldwide, inshallah. They respect each other, they have rahmah and mercy and understanding and tolerance for each other, and bring this misery in Syria, in Yemen, in Iraq, in Egypt to an end, inshallah, and strengthens the Muslim Ummah, inshallah ta'ala. A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم أمن يجيب المضطر إذا دعاه ويكشف السوء 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 يا الله من على مرضانا بالشفاء والعافية المرضى المنظورين اللهم البسهم ثوب الصحة والعافية يا أرحم الراحمين وحد كلمة المسلمين على الخير والبر والصلاح والتقوى يا أرحم الراحمين وعجل في فرج سيدنا ومولانا صاحب العصر والزمان وإلى أرواح المؤمنين والمؤمنات ثواب الفاتحة مع الصلاة على محمد وآل محمد.